So now students, let us come back to another important topic. Now that will be called electric dipole. Now again a very important topic, so we call electric dipole. So now first of all, now let us see, now what do you mean by an electric dipole? So remember, an electric dipole will always be defined a system that will be consisting of two charges which are equal in magnitude, having opposite polarity, now separated by a certain distance. Now that is what we call the electric dipole. So once again, now remember, now what will be that definition we got for the electric dipole? So electric dipole will always be defined two charges of equal magnitude having opposite polarity. Now separated by a certain distance will be generally called an electric dipole. You can clearly see, now one charge will be positive and one charge will be negative. So both of them will be having same magnitude but having opposite polarity, and moreover, now they are separated by a certain distance. Now that system will be generally called the electric dipole. Now so far we have been concentrating only on one point charge. So now we got a dipole, now meaning two charges at a time. So once again, now remember, now what do you mean by the electric dipole? So electric dipole will always be defined a system that will be consisting of two charges having equal magnitude and opposite polarity. Now separated by a certain distance is what we call the electric dipole. So remember, the system that will be consisting of two charges now having equal magnitude but opposite polarity, now separated by a certain distance, will be generally called the electric dipole. So that is the reason why the electric dipole will be having one negative charge and one positive charge. Now both will be having the same magnitude, and moreover, they are separated by a certain distance. Now that is what we call the electric dipole. So fairly simple. Now what is the meaning of the electric dipole? Now this is point O, will be generally called, it will be called the center of the dipole. So now before going to the details of the dipole, or before going into more detail of the electric dipole, now become familiar with the basic terms of the electric dipole. Now first you become familiar with the basic terminology of the electric dipole. Now let us see, now what are the basic definitions or what are the basic terminology we got for the electric dipole. Now the first one you need to remember. Now the first definition we got, now that will be generally called dipole axis. Now that will be generally called now dipole axis, or it will also be called axial line. Now let us see, now what do you mean by that dipole axis, or what do you mean by the axial line? So you can clearly see in that diagram the horizontal line that will be passing through the two charges of the electric dipole will be generally called the dipole axis, or it will also be called the axial line. So remember, the horizontal line that will be passing through both the charges of the electric dipole will be generally called the dipole axis, or it will also be called the axial line. So become familiar of this particular term. So remember, the horizontal line that will be passing through both the charges of the electric dipole will be generally called the axial line, or can also be called the dipole axis. Now that is the definition regard for the dipole axis or the axial line. Now similarly, now we got one more definition. Now that will be generally called now equatorial line. So now let us see, now what do you mean by now equatorial line, or what is the definition we got for the equatorial line? So remember, now what do you mean by the equatorial line? So remember, the vertical line that will be passing through the center of the dipole perpendicular to the dipole axis will be generally called the equatorial line. So once again, now remember, now what do you mean by the equatorial line? The vertical line that will be passing through the center of the dipole, now perpendicular to the dipole axis, will be generally called the equatorial line. So that is now one more basic term you need to remember. Now what do you mean by the equatorial line? The vertical line that will be passing through the center of the dipole perpendicular to the dipole axis will be generally called the equatorial line. So that will be another important definition regard corresponding to dipole or equatorial line. That will always be defined the vertical line that will be passing through the center of the dipole, now perpendicular to the dipole axis, will be called the equatorial line. Then similarly, now we got one more important definition. Now that will be generally called the dipole length. Now one more important definition we got, now called dipole length, now denoted by a letter to A. So you can clearly see, now what do you mean by dipole length? So remember, now that dipole length will always be defined the shortest distance that will be connecting the two charges of the electric dipole is what we call the dipole length. So remember, now the dipole length can always be defined the shortest distance that will be connecting now both the charges of the electric dipole is what we call the dipole length. and it will be denoted by a letter 2a. So once again, now have a clear cut idea. So remember, now the dipole length will always be defined the shortest distance that will be connecting now both the charges of the electric dipole is what we call the dipole length, not denoted by a letter 2a. So meaning what? From the negative charge to the center of the dipole will be small a, and from center to the positive charge it will be another small a. So the total separation between the two charges, or the total separation between the two charges, will be numerically equal to 2a. That's the reason why now the dipole length will always be defined the shortest distance that will be connecting the two charges of the electric dipole is what we call the dipole length, not denoted by a letter 2a. So remember, from the negative charge to the center of the dipole will be a, from center to the positive charge it will be another a. So the total separation between the two charges will be 2a. Now that is what we call the dipole length. Then now once you are familiar with dipole length, now one more very important definition we got. Now that will be generally called the electric dipole moment. Now let us see, now what do you mean by the electric, dipole moment that will be denoted by a letter P. So very important thing, now what do you mean by the electric dipole moment, or simply now what do you mean by the dipole moment? So remember, the dipole moment will always be defined not 2a into q. So meaning what? Now what would be the proper definition of the dipole moment? So dipole moment will always be defined as the product of the magnitude of any one of the charge and the dipole length will be generally called the dipole moment. So remember, now the dipole moment will always be defined as the product of the magnitude of any one of the charge of the dipole, and the dipole length will be generally called the electric dipole moment, not denoted by a letter P. So once again, now remember, the dipole moment capital P will always be defined as the product of the magnitude of any one of the charge and the dipole length is what we call the dipole moment. Now given by the formula, now P will be numerically equal to 2aq, or remember, the formula for the dipole moment will be given by, now P will be numerically equal to 2aq. So that will be the definition we got. Now that will be the definition we got for the dipole moment. So remember, the dipole moment will always be defined as the product of the magnitude of of any one of the charge, and that dipole length will be generally called that dipole moment, not denoted by a letter B. And remember, the formula for that dipole moment will be given by B equal to 2aq. And one more thing you remember, now the electric dipole moment is always a vector quantity, or the dipole moment is always a vector quantity whose direction will always be acting from the negative charge towards the positive charge, now along the dipole axis. So remember, not dipole moment is a vector quantity whose direction will always be acting from the negative charge towards the positive charge, now along the dipole axis. So remember, those are the terminology we got, or those are the basic definitions we got. One has to remember in order to understand the other topics related to electric dipole. So once again, remember, so the dipole moment will always be defined as the product of the magnitude of any one of the charge, and the dipole length is what we call the dipole moment, and the magnitude of the dipole moment will be given by the formula. Now capital P will be numerically equal to 2aq. And remember, now because it's a vector quantity, so the direction of the dipole moment will always be acting from the negative charge towards the positive charge, now along the dipole axis. So that is what we call the basic terminology we got. Now regarding the electric dipole, now that is the basic definitions we got. Now regarding the electric dipole, so once you are thorough with this, or once you are familiar with all these definitions, now let us come to now one more very important 4-mark question. Now based on the electric dipole, a very important one. So a very important derivation you got now based on the electric dipole. So let us see now what is the expression we got, or how we got the next topic. So now the next topic we got a very important 4-mark question. Very important 4-mark question, and that is what we call electric field. So we got electric field. Electric field intensity along the axial line. Electric field intensity along the axial line. Along the axial line of a dipole. So very important derivation we got. A very important thing. So now we are going to derive the formula for the electric field intensity along the axial line of a dipole, for now we are going to obtain the formula for the electric field. Now along the axial line of a dipole. Now let us see, now what is the formula we got, or what is the expression we got for the electric field along the axial line of an electric dipole. A very good derivation, a fantastic derivation we got for 4 marks. So now we got a small diagram. So this is the diagram we got. So I'll draw elaborately. So this is the negative charge. Now this is the positive charge of the dipole. Now this will be the center of the dipole. Now this is what we call the axial line. Now you already know, so from here to here the length will be A, and from here to here the length will be another A, so that the total length of the dipole will be 2A. Now what I am doing on the dipole axis, I am taking a point B. So now what I am doing on the dipole axis, or on the axial line, I am taking a point P, and what I am doing, I am keeping a unit positive charge at the point P. So let us say, now the distance of the point P from the center of the dipole will be small d. So always remember, now all the distances will be measured from the center of the dipole. Now let us say the distance of the point P from the center of the dipole will be small d. So now can you tell me now what will be, now can you tell me now what will be the distance of the negative charge from the point P? So what will be the distance of the negative charge from point P? Now very simple, from here to here it will be A, from here to here it will be D. So the total distance of the negative charge from the point B will be numerically equal to now D plus A. So remember that distance of the negative charge from the point P will be numerically equal to now D plus A. Now similarly, now what will be the distance of the positive charge from the point P? So now I want to find now what will be the distance of the positive charge from the point P. So very simple, from here to here it will be small a, from here to here it will be small d. So what is the remaining distance? Right, so remaining distance will be numerically equal to d minus a. So remember, the remaining distance will be d minus a, or the distance of the point P from the positive charge will be numerically equal to not D minus A. So now what is our topic we got? So now we are going to obtain now what will be the expression for the electric field intensity at any point P, now along the axial line of the dipole, or we are going to define or we are going to derive. Now what will be the expression for the electric field at any point now along the axial line of a dipole? So now I want to obtain the formula for the electric field at a point P along the axial line of a dipole. So now by looking at the diagram, now can you tell me now what will happen to the unit of positive charge now due to the negative charge? Now what will happen to the unit positive charge now due to the negative charge? So obviously the unit charge will be strongly attracted, or the unit charge will be strongly attracted towards the negative charge. That's the reason why the force of attraction F1 will be acting not towards the left side. So remember very carefully, now what will happen to the unit of positive charge now due to the negative charge? So due to negative charge, the unit charge will be strongly attracted. That's the reason why the attractive force F1 will be acting towards the left side, or the attractive force will be acting now towards the left side. Then now similarly, now what will happen to the unit of positive charge now due to the positive charge? Now what is going to happen to the unit charge now due to the positive charge of the dipole? Now due to positive charge, the unit charge will be strongly repelled. That's the reason why the repulsive force F2 will be acting outward, or due to positive charge of the dipole, now the unit charge will be strongly repelled. That's the reason why the repulsive force will always be acting outward or towards the right side. So one thing, make it very clear. Now remember, now due to the negative charge of the dipole, now the unit charge will be strongly attracted. That's the reason why the attractive force F1 will be acting inward. And similarly, now due to the positive charge, the unit charge will be strongly repelled. That's the reason why the repulsive force F2 will be acting outward or towards the right side. So that is the basic concept we got. So how the unit charge will be experiencing the electrostatic force due to negative charge and due to the positive charge. So now what we'll do, now first we'll find out now what will be the magnitude of the attractive force, or what will be the magnitude of F1 now between the negative charge and the unit charge, and both of them they are separated by a distance d plus a. So first I'm going to obtain now what will be the magnitude of the attractive force F1 now between the negative charge and the unit charge, and both of them they are separated by a distance d plus a. Now that can be obtained by applying our Coulomb's law. So according to Coulomb's law, the electrostatic force now between the two point charges will be given by the formula F will be numerically equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 naught divided by D square. So what is Q1? Now Q1 will be the magnitude of the negative charge, that will be Q. Now Q2 will be the unit charge, and the separation between them will be D plus A. So therefore, now what will be the magnitude of F1, or what will be the magnitude of the force F1? So now magnitude of F1 is, it will be given by, so F1 will be numerically equal to now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught now Q1 Q2 now divided by D square. So this is general formula we got. Now what is Q1? Now Q1 will be the magnitude of the negative charge. Now Q2 will be the magnitude of the unit charge, and the separation between them will be D plus A. So now remember here, therefore now I can write, now F1 will be numerically equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now what is Q1? So Q1 will be the magnitude of the negative charge, or Q1 will be the modulus of the negative charge. Now Q2 will be the magnitude of the unit charge, now divided by, now what is the separation between them? So the separation between them will be, so the separation between them will be now D plus A whole square. So therefore, now the magnitude of F1 will be numerically equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now you already know the modulus of the negative charge will always be positive, and modulus of 1 will be 1. So we get now Q into 1 now divided by D plus A whole square, or I can write the magnitude of F1 will be numerically equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught now Q divided by now D plus A whole square. So remember now that will be the magnitude of F1. Now similarly, now what will be the magnitude of F2, or what will be the magnitude of the repulsive force now between the positive charge and the unit charge? Now both of them, they are separated by a distance D minus A. So applying the same formula, I can write, now F2 will be numerically equal to now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, so modulus of positive charge into modulus of 1 now divided by, the separation between them will be D minus A whole square. That's the reason why now F2 will be numerically equal to now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now what we get, now Q are divided by now D minus A whole square. Now let us call it now equation number 2. So now we also got the magnitude of the repulsive force, that will be given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Now Q are divided by B minus A whole square. So now again anybody now tell me now what will be the net force that will be acting on the unit positive charge, or what will be the net force that will be acting on the unit charge. We can clearly see now the repulsive force will be greater when compared to the attractive force, or the repulsive force will be dominating when compared to the attractive force. That's the reason why the net force that will be acting on the unit positive charge will be numerically equal to F2 minus F1. So remember, now the repulsive force F2 will be dominating, or the repulsive force F2 will be dominating when compared to the attractive force F1. That's the reason why the net force that will be acting on the unit charge will be F2 minus F1. So now our job will be to find the net force that will be acting on the unit positive charge. So if you take in this one, now let us see. So what will be the net force? Now what will be the net force that will be acting on the unit positive charge? So now I can say now net force. So I can say net force acting on unit positive charge. So net force acting on unit positive charge. On unit positive charge is, now I can write, now F net will be numerically equal to the repulsive force minus the attractive force. Now why? Because the repulsive force will be more dominating when compared to the attractive force. That's the reason why the resultant force that will be acting on the unit charge will be numerically equal to now F2 minus F1. Now we already know the value of F1. We also know the value of F2. Now substitute here. So therefore, now I can write, now F net will be numerically equal to, now F2 what we got? So we got 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, now Q divided by, now we got, now T minus A whole square, now minus, this whole thing can be removed now, so diagram can also be removed. So no need of diagram now. So I can further write. So further I can write, now F1 will be given by now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, now Q are divided by now what we got, now D plus A whole square. So now you need to simplify, or now you need to further simplify to obtain the net force that will be acting on the unit positive charge. Now what further you can do, now take the common. So what is common? Now Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught can be taken common. So therefore the net force will be numerically equal to now Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught can be taken common. Then what will be remaining? in the bracket. Now we got, now 1 are divided by E minus A whole square minus 1 divided by now B plus A whole square. Now further what you do, now take the LCM. Now this term will be going here and this term will be going here. Now take the LCM. So what we get? So F net will be numerically equal to now Q are divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now take LCM. So we get now D plus A whole square now minus D minus A whole square. Now whole are divided by, now how to write the denominator? Now denominator can be written this way. Now I can write now D minus A now multiplied by E plus A whole square. So we got individual square. So for the bipartisan people, if you got x square into y square, now this can be written as a single value. Now we can write now xy whole square. So whenever you got x square into y square, now that can be written xy whole square. That's the reason why in the denominator I can write the common LCM D minus A into D plus A whole square. Now this you further simplify, or this if you further simplify, now what you are going to get? So therefore now net force will be numerically equal to now Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now open the bracket A plus B whole square. Now that will become B square plus A square plus 2AD. Now this will be now A minus B whole square. Now open the bracket. Now what you get? Now minus D square minus A square plus 2AD. 2AD, now whole are divided by, now what we are getting in the denominator, so if you look here, now A minus B into A plus B will be A square minus B square whole square. So we are getting now D minus A into D plus A whole square. So A minus B into A plus B will become A square minus B square whole square. So meaning in the denominator we are going to get now B square minus A square whole square. So D square minus A square whole square. So if you look at the formula, now what is getting cancelled? Now D square minus D square plus A square minus A square will be getting cancelled. Then what will be remaining? So I will write here so that I can have enough space. Instead of writing congestionally, I can write here. So now if you further simplify, now what will be remaining? So what will be remaining? Now F net will be numerically equal to now Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now multiplied by, now what will be remaining? Now 2AD plus 2AD. Now that will become now 4AD. Now whole divided by now D square minus A square whole square. Now this can be further simplified. Now what I will do, I will rearrange the formula. So here now what I am doing, I am rearranging the formula. I am writing this way. So or further I can write Now F net will be numerically equal to, now what I will do, I will take Q inside. Now this can be written, now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, now whole multiplied by, now what I am doing, I am taking Q inside. Now this can be written this way, so I can write, now 2aq, now multiplied by, I can write 2d. Now look at the numerator, now what I am doing, I am taking Q inside, so what it will become, so it will become, it will become, now 4q into ad, now that I am writing in a simple form, now 2aq, now multiplied by 2d. So just remember, now what I am doing, I am splitting 4, now 4 can be written 2 into 2, I am pulling a q inside, so what I can write, now 2aq, now multiplied by 2d, now whole divided by, now d square minus a square whole square. So now, why we are writing this way? Now because, now we already know, now what is 2aq? Now 2aq will be generally called the dipole moment of the electric dipole, or 2aq will be generally called the dipole moment of the dipole, now denoted by a letter capital P. That's the reason why I am rearranging the formula in the numerator. Now what I am doing, I am splitting 4, 2 into 2, so I can write 2aq multiplied by 2d whole divided by d square minus a square whole square. Now remember, now 2aq is nothing but the electric dipole moment, or 2aq will be generally called the dipole moment of the dipole. So therefore, now I can write the net force will be numerically equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, now this will become capital P, so what I am getting, now 2p into d, now whole divided by d square minus a square whole square. So therefore, now what I am getting, the net force that will be acting on the unit positive charge, or the net force that will be acting on the unit charge will be given by, now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2pd, now divided by d square minus a square whole square. Now this can be further simplified. Now this can be further simplified, but you remember, now what is the definition of the electric field intensity? Now remember, the electric field intensity will always be defined the net force that will be experienced by a unit positive charge. You remember, now what is the standard definition of the electric field intensity? So electric intensity will always be defined the force that will be experienced by a unit positive charge at any point inside the electric field is what we call the electric intensity. That's the reason why the electric intensity will be numerically equal to the net force that will be experienced by the unit of positive charge. So now, substitute the value of net force. So therefore, the electric intensity. So electric intensity on the axial line, now E axial will be numerically equal to the net force that will be experienced by the unit of positive charge. So already I told you, now what is the standard definition of electric intensity? Now electric intensity will always be defined as the force experienced by a unit of positive charge at any point inside the electric field. So meaning, now whatever the net force that will be experienced by the unit charge, or whatever net force that will be experienced by the unit positive charge will be generally called the electric field intensity along the axial line. That is the reason why now I can write E axial will be numerically equal to F net. Now F net we already got, that will be numerically equal to now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught now 2 pd now divided by now d square minus a square whole square. So remember, now this will be the formula we got, or this will be the formula we got for the electric field along the axial line of a long dipole. So remember, now this is the formula we got, or this is the expression we got for the electric field now due to a long dipole now along the axial line. So now we need to obtain the formula for the electric field now due to the short dipole, or now we need to obtain the formula for the electric field due to short dipole. So remember the concept, now whatever formula we got or whatever expression we got, now this is the electric field that will be contributed by a long dipole now along the axial line, and now we need to obtain now what will be the electric field that will be contributed by a short dipole. So let us see now what is the condition we got to obtain the electric field now due to a short dipole, or what is the condition we got to obtain the electric field now due to a short dipole. So remember, derivation is not yet over. Now we need to obtain for short dipole, now then only you will be getting 4 marks. Now otherwise you won't be getting the complete 4 marks. So now let us see now what will happen for short dipole. Now what is the condition we got for short dipole? Now remember, for a shorter dipole or for small dipole, now remember the condition will be, now here the external distance will be greater than small a, or remember for a shorter dipole or for a small dipole, now external distance small d will be greater than small a. So therefore, now under this approximation, now what will happen to the denominator? So under this approximation, now what will happen to the denominator? So therefore, the denominator, now d square minus a square will be approximately equal to d square itself. Now why? Because now A will be negligibly small, or A will be negligibly small. So A square will be further negligible. That's the reason why now D square minus A square will be approximately equal to D square. Now then, if I substitute here, I will be getting the formula for the electric field that will be contributed by a shorter dipole, or the electric field that will be contributed by a small dipole. So therefore, now I can write now electric field along the axial line of a short dipole can be written by now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught now multiplied by 2 pv all divided by now what is d square minus a square. So d square minus a square will be d square. So d square now whole power, now we got another square. Now this is going to become, so E axial will be numerically equal to now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught now 2 pv now divided by e power 4. So d power 4 and d will get cancelled. Now finally, now what we are getting, now the electric field along the axial line of a short dipole will be given by the formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught now we got now 2 p now divided by e cube. So remember, so this will be the formula we got, or this is the expression we got for the electric field now due to a short dipole now along the axial line. So first we need to obtain the formula for a long dipole, and then after that we need to obtain the formula for the electric field that will be contributed by the short dipole that will be given by E axial will be numerically equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught now 2 p divided by dq. So that is a beautiful expression we got, very very important one for 4 marks. So hope you have all understood.